Hello and welcome to my channel. I'm Brittany. Usually I make content on Patreon full time, but I've been kind of dabbling back into YouTube because I love it and I love talking to you guys. Also, I really want to talk to Abba and Preach or anyone else who I think might have interesting conversations with me on a level of like great introspection, but also like relatability. And I can't do that unless I share my shit on YouTube and make sure they know like, hey, I'm a person and I want to talk to you because I think we could have stuff to talk about, please. Okay, thanks, bye. The reason I bring this up is because the internet and the universe was working in my favor this week, guys. Like, check out this craziness. In the last couple weeks, I contacted another YouTuber and I wanted to talk to them about philosophy and politics and stuff, and we've hit it off. It's been really nice. And we were talking about how weird it is knowing that we are like a part of like a weird few people who like are actually like YouTubers. Like, we're content creators, we're public figures, and it's weird. Like, I was thinking, out of all 10 kids in my big ass Middle Eastern family, like, why was I the only one who pursued something and honestly like is successful? Like, I consider myself a successful content creator, and so it's just kind of strange, I guess, realizing like how different that life is. Like, even the people I've dated, and thank God my 20s is so over, but I realized like people really did date me in a fantasy way. Like, often they always brought up YouTube. Like, everyone I've ever been with has always brought up YouTube, and they were never YouTubers, but always people who talked about being on YouTube or talked about doing something with their lives but never did. And it's one of those things where like I realized, like, as a YouTuber, as a content creator, I've done something that a lot of people haven't done. I've done a thing that kids in high school are now wanting to grow up to be, which for me blows my mind because I never saw myself as that person. Like, that's a real thing. Like, as much as I saw myself as a successful author or something else, I never really saw myself like a celebrity. Like, I always looked at celebrities like, oh, that's a world I do not want, because I don't like reality TV. I don't like celebrity culture. I don't like this obsession with like people who are famous for nothing. Like, I don't understand it. But I've realized like I'm a part of this ecosystem, and in this ecosystem there are those realities with YouTubers. There are different levels of intimacy with YouTubers. Like, I belong on a very specific side of YouTube, and I'm actually trying to transition to a different side of YouTube because I'm embracing my TOF. To be completely honest, I've tried so hard to cater my language to most people when I realize I'm just not like most people, and I'm just gonna talk the way I talk like normal and attract the people who are like me, because God bless, I'm wonderful, and I would like to meet more people who are interested in the things that I'm interested in the way that I'm interested in them. And that's why I was so excited when YouTube recommended a video by Abba and Peach, and it's called We're Not Friends, Why You Mad? And right away I was like, oh shit, is this the universe like finishing up this? I was thinking about making a video about how weird it is that I'm a YouTuber in social context, but this video even made it better. So in this video, They're reviewing an athlete who's on a soccer team, football, and he's talking about how after the game is done, yeah, like, we're coworkers, we love each other, there's a camaraderie, totally, a brotherhood, but after, it doesn't mean we're friends, it doesn't mean they're my 2 a.m. calls.
When people found out that, like, we weren't close friends, they got so upset.
You're mad at something that we're not even mad about.
If you look at two professional athletes, and they work professionally, but they're not friends.
How is Michael Jordan not friends with Scottie Pippen? Like, chill, it's high.
They see us laughing, they see us having this chemistry, and they don't recognize as comedians is just what we do. Like, I can sit down with any comedian, even if they're not my friends. Not any comedian, but most comedians.
No, I was like about to say, yeah.
But you know what I mean? Like, comedians that you get along with, but you're not friends with.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And you guys start chopping it up, and it's just natural.
Yeah.
Because that's what we do.
And we've been doing it consistently for like 4 years, so plus we're going to have like a certain rhythm to this.
Yeah,
like that.
It's not because you enjoy success together you necessarily have to be friends.
And Abba and Preach agreed that they felt like their relationship was sort of similar, where they were comedians, and when they talk to each other, it's not the same as talking to civilians. And I feel the same way. I feel completely separated from most people a lot of the time, because I am. Like, my job is weird. I work from home most of the time. Like, I take jobs in town with, like, my professional, normal people job is, like, childcare, and I'm really good at it, and I love doing it. And I even do it now, and it's such a blessing, but a gift. But I primarily have been doing this for 3 years without doing anything else, and I traveled, and I live this life, and I go to events, and I talk to people, and I'm supposed to shake hands, and it's like a big deal, and I'm just sitting here scratching my head like, this isn't what I wanted, because the level of intimacy between YouTubers is very similar to a company. A lot of it is levels. We know each other, we're kind of friendly, we might take photos together, we might even follow each other on Twitter, but we never even talk to each other. I know nothing about this person, or, you know, we don't actually have like that kind of a friendship. And then there's like friendships that are a little more intimate, and Abba and Peach kind of, Peach? Anyways, so Abba and Preach talked about this, how they have a really wonderful intimate relationship, but they didn't consider themselves necessarily like homies. This is very specific, and maybe it's a language barrier, but their audience was really hurt by this. An observation of their comments, their audience really felt like these men were in denial. Some even suggesting that Abba should go to therapy because he obviously has issues with intimacy. This is very interesting because for me, when I saw that video, I'm like, yep, that be life. And then when other people saw it, they were like, this is crazy. But every time you've seen me in a video with your faves, every time I've been in an event, every time one of your faves asked me for nudes or to play with me or whatever else, they've all ghosted, they've all flaked, they've all been people who faked friendships. Like, YouTube is just a business. Like, there is just like, that is the ultimate truth of it. And sometimes you make real friends. Like, Evie Lupine and I, we're real friends. Like, she's considered somebody who's a real friend to me, right? And that's important. And she's like the only YouTuber that's like, that you might know that I'm like, this is 100% my friend. You know what I mean? If you're a YouTuber, by the way, and you're thinking in your head, oh my God, is Brittany thinking that we're not friends? Very possibly, but I mean that in like a non-offensive way. I mean, I'm friends with a lot of YouTubers that are like, we're friendly. When we see each other, it's so much fun. I hope them all the happiness in the world, but we don't call each other when it matters. They're not gonna meet my family. They're not people who are gonna be at my wedding necessarily. Like, there is levels of intimacy we have with people. It's when I see celebrity culture and I notice some people aren't invited to some people's weddings, like when Josh Peck didn't invite Drake to his wedding, like, that was a big deal. Like, Drake not showing up was a big deal. But to be honest, like, even if you've worked together and you think like you're all gonna be friends, sometimes you grow up not to be because your lives go in different directions. And I think that's what maturity is. I think when you're young, you cling to this idea that everyone is your friend. But we're not. We don't want to be. Please stop asking me to be your friend. If we're meant to be friends, you'll not have to ask. It will happen organically. And that's the point. I don't treat people like they're like their celebrityism is important or who they are or their status is important. And I want the same for myself. The mistake I made in my mid-20s was thinking that because we were all YouTubers meeting each other, we were all on the same page of being honest and transparent. What I discovered is most YouTubers, men and women, they ghost you, they don't know how to tell you that they want to be friends, they don't know how to tell you they want to keep it professional. And that is strange to me. I'm a very blunt person. I think it's much kinder. I think there's more compassion if you tell a person, thank you so much for doing this collab with me. I love working with you. Let's keep this a working relationship. I don't know, guys, this is so important. The fact that I can watch a video by Abba and Preach and feel like, yes, 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 call me. Yes, yes, yes. And the majority of their audience watches it and doesn't get it. So the question is, what is a friend? And a friend is subjective. I'm gonna share my personal chart of how I kind of decipher what a friend is and what level you're at. It's really simple for me, okay? I try to keep my life really categorized simply. Okay, there's the inner circle. That's my biological family, okay? They are ride or die. And then there's the three non-related people to me by blood who are chosen family that I've allowed in the inner circle. There's one more space in this inner circle available, and it is for the person who will give me 17 babies. Or who I will give 17 babies, because I'm bisexual. Okay, so like, that is the last space I have open in my inner circle. But then there's like the outer inner circle, and those are the people who are like, we're close, we go to each other's weddings, we give each other's gifts, we're wonderful, sometimes we're each other's 2 a.m. calls, but we're not the people you would necessarily call to bury a body. And I think that's really important. I think it's really important to know the difference between the people you would call to help you bury a body, because you don't want to be caught, versus the people you go to theaters with, or brunch with, or dates with, or have sex with even. Like, I'm serious. There is a lot I will do with my inner outer circle that I might, like, you know what I mean? Like, my inner outer circle, you get what I'm saying. Okay, that's either gonna make sense or it's not. I'm not tailoring my language to try to explain it to the internet, who can't even figure out basic sentences sometimes. So I'm gonna leave it there. So the third layer, so that there's inner circle, inner outer circle, and outer circle. An outer circle is like all of my patrons. They're all people I've talked to personally. They're all people I send DMs to. They're all people that, like, they know parts of me that are really intimate. They're like people who know me more than a stranger would know me, but they're still strangers. And sometimes those strangers become inner outer circle, but it's really rare and it almost never happens. You know what I mean? But most of the time, they're just, it's that parasocial relationship that starts at that end, where it's like people who know you. Like, you ever lived in a neighborhood so long that when you go back to visit, the same neighbors know you? And it's like when we were kids, we were friends, but now we're all adults, so like you were my kid friends. It's like those people are still in your life, but they're not in the inner circle. It's not like you talk to them, but they're still more than a stranger. Yes. Okay, I think I've said everything I want to say to the internet. Oh my God, guys, I had this epiphany the other day because I took like months and months off of YouTube and I thought I was going away forever. And then I realized it. Fuck it, I love it. I'm a whore. What can I say? But like, you know what's so crazy is I was posting a video and I felt that anxiety build up again. And I was like, oh, I remember what it's like. Being a public figure is so strange, because every time I post a video, I'm like, is this going to get me another stalker? And I have been severely noticing a huge lack of compassion in the world. And compassion means to suffer with. It means you literally have to be humble enough to imagine life as another person for long enough to see them as a human. And on top of that, be smart enough to observe that they're still strangers and there's still a level of, like, if the zombie apocalypse happens, I will murder everyone who's not in my inner circle. So just like, if you come for my resources. But if you don't come for my resources, we good. You know, like, I'm very protective of my inner circle. Very, you know, it's, I don't see a lot of loyalty, kids. Not a lot of loyalty. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna go now. Thank you for watching. Abba or Preach, if you see this, like, slide into the email, because I don't have social media. Okay, talk to you guys later. Have a great day. Bye.